And then I get like, okay, I need to saikai. I guess I'll do it next week. Mm. And it's like, oh, 今日できますよ. Really?
I think recently also in Malaysia, they also have this kind of system where after you send, you have to take a picture saying the owner has received it with the package.
Oh, so with the owner.
And the people will just start posing funny.
I got it!
マジでこのくらいの速度でみんな走られてる。走っていただいている。今日は海外が驚く日本の配達サービスの凄さについて話してみよう。
Let's find out!
こんにちは、全人類の友達になろうと思うからミスターです。そして
ミスターマ
ヨネーズ
アナです。
アナです。
アマゾンって便利ですよね。
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Yeah, around the world, yeah.
It's not bad.
Except North Korea.
Nice.
YouTube 始めてから Amazon めっちゃ使う機会増えて、っていうのも、まあ、今日も1個ね動画撮ったけれども、企画で使う道具とかを Amazon で取り寄せたりするのよ、
うん、
でその時にたくさんこれ便利だねみたいな話をしたら、特にポールがめっちゃ便利だよっていう。
そうだね。確かに日本の配達サービスはマジで正解しかったと思います。
しかも感動ということなので、今日のテーマはプリン、海外が驚く日本配達サービスの凄さについて。
Japanese 配達 What a dream. It's so safe. Nobody steals your packages away from you.
There's no economy of stealing your other people's packages.
That's right.
ちょっと後で聞こうかな。ちょっと気になるけれども、もうすでにね。はい、まあ、みんなの国と比べて日本の配達サービス特に秀でてるんじゃないですかって話があったので、まあ、みんなの国とのこの比較っていうのをね、今日は喋っていきたいと思います。
はい、
それでは行ってみましょう。
はい、お
とに。1個目、ちゃんと届く。
確かに、
oh, ね、yeah, yeah.
ちょっと分からん分からん、ない普通届くくない。
No.
For you, yeah.
Well, yeah, in Japan it's okay, but...
I mean, most of the times it does, but...
There's the occasional... Occasion. There's the occasional occasion where it just doesn't show up.
Yeah.
You know, the whole meme, it's like USPS, United States Postal Service, they just lose packages all the time.
Exactly. Yeah. You know?
It just disappears.
The Philippines has a shirt instead of FedEx, which is a company, it says... Fed up because the mail doesn't get there. Ooh,
oh.
Burn!
Got him.
Yeah.
Beat that.
Get that fed up.
本当になくなったことある？
ある。
何なくなった？
手紙。
手紙？
Like I sent a 手紙 from Japan to Romania. I never got to my family.
It's because the water buffalo dropped it on the way there.
So you wouldn't know whether it's Japan's fault or the Romania.
そうそうそう。日本のフォルトの可能性もあるよね。
But like even in Romania where you send inside the country, right? Me personally, I didn't have instances because we just didn't order that many stuff because like you tend to not order stuff as often when there's a chance of it getting lost, right? Mm-hmm. But I've had around me people who are like, oh.That thing just never came. It got lost.
In Malaysia, we actually have a few news before saying that they found a lot of unsent letter dumped at the roadside.
What?
Roadside?
Yeah. Yes. They found it and then they was like, what?
What?
Oh man.
で、なんで？まあ、ただポストマンがやりたくないだから、仕事終わりました。
もうやめる！
Oh my god.
Oh god.
We had those news before, so.
This is your grandmother's will and testament to the through the mail. I entrust my fund of $100 million to you, Maximilian. Boy!
Well, we used to have it, but I'm not sure whether they have improved the system right now, but this is the situation
in the countries, yeah.なんか荷物届かないイメージ思い浮かばない、全然。だから多分めっちゃ事件だと思う、もしそれを誰かがちゃんと届けてなかったとしたら、もう全国ニュースになると思う。
I remember using Amazon customer service a lot when they would lose my packages, right? Because I mean, they started even the delivery guy had to start taking pictures that your package has arrived to your premises safely because that was happening way too much, right? And so they would deliver the package, take the package, your package is delivered, so it's not our fault if your package gets stolen or not on your porch.
Regarding the taking pictures part, I think recently also in Malaysia, they also have this kind of system where after you send, you have to take a picture saying the owner has received it with the package.
Oh, so with the owner!
And the people just start posing funny.
I got it! I got it!
あとさ、なんかちゃんと届くっていう意味で言ったら、よく YouTube に流れてくるのがアメリカの監視カメラの映像、
ね、
で、配達員がなんかちょっと投げるというか、なんかあれはああいうあんまり普通じゃないなんていうことだった。
アメリカ is home to a lot of throwing sports.
そっちか。
Nice.
Here's the thing. So there's a lot of cases where people are ordering really expensive and fragile computer parts, right? And there's a lot of cases where the delivery guys just want to speed run the whole way through. And they're lazy, you know? They're not thinking about the other person. They're thinking about, how can I do this job the fastest? And, you know, look, maybe I'll take a risk that there's no expensive item inside this box. So what are they going to do? They're going to throw it just like, I don't know, the newspaper boy... Oh, sorry, I spit on your face.
It's okay.
You know that those movies where like there's a newspaper, paper, get your papers, and he would throw it, yeah. And he would try to like do like a trick shot so that it lands directly on the door. I think that Amazon shippers are doing the same thing to throw the box, and then you just end up with like a super like boro-boro no box and a boro-boro no AMD graphics card. And so, what's it called? There's a lot of programs. I think that the most popular company is Nest, where there's a camera on the doorbell, right? And so it records movement. So anything that gets left at your front door, it turns on immediately when it senses movement. So the owner can see what the delivery person is doing with your packages. Mm. And so if they get that
air.
Exactly. If they get that footage, then they have evidence to use against you in court saying, hey, this guy really abused my package and should get punished for it, and I deserve compensation for it. Here's the evidence, right?
Yes. Yes. Isn't it, for example, the Amazon, the delivering service, it's not hired by the Amazon company, they just like...
They outsource the people.
Kind of like, what, TaskRabbit?
Like TaskRabbit, okay.
That's why not professionals' way of sending...
That's right. It's like trying to order an Uber, but instead you just get like a guy who has hands who can deliver you the package instead, right?
That's why they're always in like unmarked cars, right? Like Sagawa, for example, they have like Sagawa trucks and they have like Sagawa people to like, deliver it, right? But like Amazon's always like some dude
in
his car, right? Yeah.
Right.
Which is why they ask them to wear, what do you call that? The Amazon's...
Like a vest or something.
Vest or something when you're doing your job.
That's right, yeah. Well, in America, we have this epidemic called porch pirates. And from the name, you can pretty much understand what that pirates. Is. Think of a pirate. Exactly. So that's what it's called. And so they're there and they wait for the delivery guy to come to your house. And then when they know that this owner is out of town, they steal the package. Especially like big boxes because...
Those are hot ticket items.
Yeah, those are hot items. Maybe there's like a PS5. It's a phenomenon that has happened so bad that there's a YouTuber, he's like engineer Mark Rober. You guys know?
You
saw that, right?
The glitter box, right?
Yeah, the glitter box. The glitter box thing bomb.
That's the show.
So he wanted to get back at Porch Pirate. So he put like a fake expensive like headphone case. And then when they brought it home, there was like a sound bite. And it's like, alarm setting off in 10, 9. And it was like a bomb, right? Yeah, and as soon as the countdown stopped, it would release like a stink bomb and glitter. And glitter, right? And it was just a robot, and then there was like cameras, like four-way cameras all around, and you could just see people go like, oh god, what the heck?
Oh man. And then there was like ink and
He's making that because America is facing a phenomenon of so many porch pirates out there stealing people's packages from their door.
Right?
Yes. Well, that, to protect your home, number one, and also, to protect yourself from porch pirates. Exactly.
Yeah. 日本は監視カメラある家の方が全然少ない。 気がするね、なんか。
You need to protect yourself and your family, and you need to have evidence from people who try to steal your packages.
Isn't it there's a joke saying that if you bought a new TV, you want to get rid of a second-hand TV, you just put it back into the box and just put it outside of your house, someone's gonna take it.
Someone will take it, yeah, exactly. If you leave your junk outside of your house in America, chances are that's gonna be gone in the matter of like a day. Like somebody's gonna go like, take their pickup truck over to your house and pick it up.
That's the thing in like in Canada too, like in Japan, you have to get like the Solagomi sticker.
Yeah, it's very annoying.
It's like a whole process, right? But like in Canada, you just put it on the side of the road, someone will come.
That sounds so rakuchin for the Solagomi.
Nice. ちなみに宅配ボックスとかみんなの国の家にはない。それがあれば取っていくとか大丈夫です
よ。家によって違うな。
They just pop in front of your door and that's it.
Why do I feel like by what I've been hearing now from the American, even if you would have宅配 boxes in front of your porch, people would still get taken.
The whole time.
Yeah. Or if it was like, let's say it was like at best case scenario, it was like built into the home. Someone would
bust out. Yeah, is a joke, not
dude. That's what happened with the vending machine.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Like Japan tried to use it through the vending machines, and they tried it. I think in Detroit or something like that.
It was destroyed.
ということでちゃんと届くでした。はい。ちゃんと届く。は
い。納得できない日本人。
次、早い。
マジ
で。それは早い。
If you have an Amazon logistics center near your house, you definitely can get the item on the same day. I actually had experience with my shoes that just got spoiled or ruined. And then I just order online in the morning. And when I get back, I already got the shoes in front of my house.
They over-deliver way too much in Japan, which is kind of like a hassle. It's like, oh, it'll get here on this day, and they send it to you at like 9 in the morning. Bro, you guys are overachievers. Just let me sleep in. It's Saturday, man. Come at 11 or 11:30.
You can choose that sometimes in Romania too. You tell them like, please come at Gogo, right? And that's usually between 1 and 5 p.m., right? They always come at 5:30 p.m.
確かに大阪から東京とかに荷物送ったとしても次の日にはも
う
ハガキとかも届くよね。
そうですよ。それは本当にすごいと思います。ハガキがマジでって思いました。70円しか払ってないんじゃないかなと思って。
そう、今いくらなんだ？63だって。
うん。それだけ払って、もちろん3時以前送ったら次の日届くん。
詳しいな。
よく調べたから。
マレーシアはもうちょっと時間かかる。
ちょっと時間があると思います。多分、少なくとも3ビジネスデーかな。
あ、そうなんや。
多分日本ってビジネスデーのコンセプトはない気がする。Days だけ。
Every day is business day in Japan.
めちゃくちゃ早いです。
So, I have a personal anecdote about this. I like to order 赤福 from time to time.It's like mochi tsutsumu in anko. It's really, really good. You guys have that before? It's right there.
Nice. It's right there.
It's right there! Oh! Oh!
Anyway, they properly todoku at the time when the show me kigen starts. So they properly show me the kigen, you know? And then, here's the kigen. Thank you very much for showing me. And then it todokus to your house right at the start so that you can motsu for as long as possible. Oh, I mean, nice. These things are only good for like, what, 1 week?
Okay.
Right? Because other than that, the anko is going to start getting hard and the mochi is not going to taste as good, right? They properly deliver it when you can have it at the best time possible, right? And they do that super fast. Mm. So when you're ordering stuff like this that can go bad easily in a matter of days, they're very good at doing it properly. And I can have meibutsu from anywhere around the country because Japan is so efficient.
Yeah, I wouldn't even think of ordering this kind of 商品 in Romania.
みんなの国に比べると遠くからでも次の日来るから早いかなって感じ。
早い。
早い。
あとまあ僕が個人的に思うのは 黒猫ヤマトの宅急便とか、あの、まあ、他の宅配会社さんも走って商品届けてる、まあ、見たことある？あんまない。
あんま言われたら多分あるかもしれないけど、あんまり気づいてないです。してる。
え、マジで？これ走ってるけど、マジでこのくらいの速度でみんな走られてる。走っていただいている。うん、でこんな感じだから、まあ、より速いのかなと思って。だから走った方がさ、あの、捌ける量は絶対増えるじゃん。
まあまあ。
だから次の日に届けるとかも、ああやって走ってくださっている宅配民の方々に助けられているのかなと思って。これどう？みんなの国で走ってる？
いや絶対ないよ。
No, no way. Yeah.
You know what runs the box through the air?
あ、速度速い。正直僕もこれは大丈夫かなってちょっと心配になる。ここまでしなくてもとは思うけど、でもお疲れ様です。
そうそう。いや、I appreciate
感謝してますよ、yeah. 本当に。
I really want to wear one of these uniforms.
ヤマト宅急便の。
Yeah. And run a marathon with it, like an empty box and just like do this the whole time.
It's like a, you know, RPGs. Like you depending on what armor set you wear, you get like a plus 10 agility bonus.
Plus 10 speed.
Yeah. It's probably Suzushi, man. You know, yeah, like, yeah. It looks kind of thin, doesn't it? Because they have to run in it.
It's a good hat too.
Yeah, they're doing Taiso in it, dude. So you can work out in those clothes.
宅配してくださる方々、ありがとうございます。
あと、例えば再配達になった時に時間は指定できますね。次再配達するくれると。違う。
うんうん。
それは良くない？
No, no. Like,
普通できるんじゃない？
Dude, no. The crazy thing is that you can have it delivered the same day again.
Yes. If before 5 p.m. you can actually call in.
That's right. Because I miss my morning time sometimes, and then the Fuzai. Right. comes in the mail, and then I get like, okay, I need to saikai. I guess I'll do it next week. Mm. And it's like, oh, 今日できますよ。Really?
Yeah, it's so pumped in.
Right. Sometimes only if I failed the time limit and I just do the side haitatsu for tomorrow.
Yeah.
If the haitatsu is solid, he will come to see whether I can accept it today.
That's crazy, yeah. Dude. Man, you guys are super efficient, man. Americans would not care.
それはあんま普通じゃない。
普通じゃない。
ないことない。ない。
No way.
日本以外に住んだことないんで。
ありがたいですね。
確かにめちゃくちゃありがたいと思ったのは、
本当ですよ。
あの、今日撮影で使いたい道具があったよね。まあ、あの、かき氷機なんだけど、で、かき氷機、本当は昨日届くはずだったんだけど、まあ、なんか手違いで、ちょっと届かなくって。で、あの、届かないんですけどって言ったら、明日ごめんなさい、再配達させてもらいますって言われて、明日の何時くらいですかね、明日必要なんで、ちょっとそこは明確にしときたいんですって言ったら、あ、もうじゃあ今日ちょっと頑張って持っていきます。えってな
って。そうそう
そう。ありがとうございます。
本当にありがたいですね、そういうサービス。
てか、自分で荷物出すんだったら、時間指定はできるじゃん。
うん。
あれもできない。あれはできる。
You can do it the day.
うん、day. We can do it
the day.
あ、そうなんや。じゃあ、午前中に配達とかできない
？No.
No. あんまり経験したことないな。
でもなんか、一個だけ不思議だなと思うのが、日本の配達サービスがなかなか電話してこない。
だから電話を避けるためにそういうシステムがあるんですから。
でも逆に電話したら時間かかるでしょ。
そうそう。逆に電話したら宅配員の方の時間を使っちゃうから。
あ、でも気持ちがわかる。
あの、たまにさ、不在ですって言われて、いやでもいた。だから不在って気づいた時に、その不在票を入れる前に一回電話してほしい。
たまに手紙もらうじゃないですか。この人じゃないと受けない。
はい。本人だけしか受け取れない手紙とか、ね。
そうそうそう、はい。身分確認しないといけないじゃないですか。日本のいろんな入力システムがわからないんですけど、みんな統一してなくて、たまに漢字とか入れたり、カタカナとか入れたり、ハリガナ入れたり、ロマ字入れたり。うん、僕の身分証は漢字のやつがなくて、でも僕はあそこの入力システムで漢字に入れてたんだけど、漢字の名前を確認しないといけないから、確認するとき僕それの身分証を持ってなくて、確認できなくて、そのまま持って帰って僕の目の前に、
目の前に That's mine and you're walking
This is not you. You are in fact not Paul. Goodbye.
本当にすみませんですけど、これ漢字書いてある身分証あるんですか？すみません、ないんですよ。作ってくれないからないんですよ。
But that's me.
That's me.
丸み正しい。
No, I mean, they're just doing their job.
I know, I know, I know.
難しいよね、それは。だから、
it's not their fault, it's the company system fault.
それでもむずいよね。ポールの名前は中華系の名前だから、ポールじゃない名前があるよね。で、それをカタカナか英語か何かで表しているのは持ってるけど、日本人かしたらそれ読めないから、漢字でこの人に絶対渡してくださいって漢字読んでも、一緒多分なっちゃうよ、それは。さすがに渡せないよ、それは。その人を責めるのは。
じゃあ、僕のカタカナ入力できるシステム作ってくれたらいいと思いますよ。
それはまた別の話。はい、ということで、早いでした。次、
はい、
無料サービスが多い。
お茶
はい。
ずっとどういう話
お茶はタダですよ。
ご飯屋さん行った時にタダで出してくれるお茶、これ海外にはあります、どうでもいいよ説明さすない
いと思ってるのは、転送サービス。
ああ、引っ越した時とかのやつ。
そうです、それは助かりますよ、本当に。たまにいろんなこと、自分の住所登録してるから登録し直しないといけないのは分からなかったから、それやってたら、まあ、転送のシールが貼ってたら、まあ、ここはまだ変更してないよって分かるんですよね、引っ越した後に。
ああ、そうね、
うん、
でも、まあ、普通っていうことしない？みんなもさ、それは海外から来てるから引っ越す機会が多いと思うけど、日本は引っ越した時に前の住所と今の新しい住所を紐付けて引っ越しましたっていうその申請を出したら、1年間は古い住所に来たやつも自分の名前だったら転送してくれるよね、
うんうんうん、僕も当たり前のことだと思いましたけど、一回マレーシアのサービス調べててなかったんだ、うん、僕もまあ家族に言ってこれ申請したらいいんじゃんって調べたらないよって
じゃあ昔の住所に届いちゃうってこと？
うん、どうなってるんかなと思いました。
This is not me. It's actually not me though.
でもよくあるよ。知らない人の手紙とか自分の住所に届くのはよくあったね、マレーシアは。
だからロストしてるんじゃないの？
ロストっていうか、それはロストじゃない。捨てるだけですよ。
でもアメリカとかはあるんじゃない？聞いたことあるけど、転送サービスある。
一応あるけど、めっちゃお金かかるんですよ。
あ、そうなの？
Yeah, it's not free at all. It's like...You have to pay like $60 or something like that. You have to pay like an unreasonable amount for something that is free in Japan.
In Japan, I think that when I moved around in Tokyo, they said that I either have to have the todoke or I just show them my number card. And so they have that service, and that service is free if you need to change addresses. But if you want to change your address in the States, let's say that you need a new address on your driver's license, that's aboutaround like $85 to get like a new one.
アメリカとかカナダのやつをさ、国営国がやってる。
Yeah, yeah.
UPSS. なんでお金かかるのね。
Because America likes to bleed you dry of all your money until you are homeless.
Yeah.
Yeah. まあもう一ついいと思うのは、集荷サービスをやってくれるってことですね。
あ、荷物をまあ集めに来てくれる、
ね。そうそうそうそう。自分の自宅に。
That's cool.
集荷しに来る。
黒猫ヤマトとか郵便局は多分普通に無料でやってくれるよね。
そうです。
追加料金ヤマトさんかかりません。
Wow.
Good for you, Japan.Must be nice.
I used it once from JB Post. They actually helped bring the label to my house for me to fill it.
The label too?
Yes.
Wow.
I don't have to prepare it myself.
That's
great. They just bring it to my place and I can fill it. Let's say you want to have a package box for you to put in your stuff and stuff. You can actually order it online.
That's cool.
Then they bring it to you and then you pack it at a spot and then they just take it from there.
Oh, oh, yeah. The only thing that exists in America I remember doing as a kid is not for like big packages, but if you want to send a letter, you go outside to your mailbox, you get the mail that got delivered, you put the mail that you want to send in the box, and then each mailbox has a little flag that you put up. So the next time the mailman comes, he sees the flag up, and then he knows to take that letter to deliver, and then he puts your new mail in the mailbox. But that's it. That still costs postage.But they don't deliver like big boxes for you. And I think a system that's often used in Japan is that they send like appliances for you. Like they can send a washing machine to a different house for you, and you just tell them to come to your house, pick it up, like Sagawa or like Kuroneko. They can just come to your house, pick it up, and they send it. I think that's what I used when I moved from Osaka to Tokyo. I just had boxes, like six boxes prepared. Okay, send it all off, and then they're like, okay, ichimayen, boom, and they got sent to Tokyo.
I think I used that service before. Yeah. 単身パックの、
パックね。
because パック、
no.
Which is not 無料、but still, it's really convenient.
That's super convenient. It's super cheap. でも、シュガーサービスは、まあ、ちょっと、レイジーの話ですけど、まあ、平日、みんな仕事でしょ。
うん、
郵便局も空いてる間に行けないんじゃん。でも、土日なら、ある本店だけがしか空いてないじゃん。
うん、
たまに遠いから、それがあったら結構助かります。
うん、ああ、確かに。
ということで、無料サービスが多いでした。うん、次、
はい、
ハイテク。
Yes。
これは正直ちょっと意外なんですけど。
なんで？なんで
？My image of post service、
okay.
is just traditional,
yeah,
run organizations. I wouldn't expect a lot of like high tech things. Maybe disinfect machine.
Oh well, okay, yeah.
ファックス使う国がハイテクだなんてありえない。まあまあ、
そういうイメージだ。
それは確かにそう。
Postage and stuff like that, like in my head, I'm kind of conflicted because on the one hand, postage has always been like it's run by the country, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And if you love your country, you should make it traditional as possible, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm thinking.Letters in a burlap sack pulled by a water buffalo, drawn through the fields, and you wait for 4 weeks to arrive. You sit on your porch chewing on wheat, right?
Is that not special for you?
Anyway, and so like on the one hand, I want my postage service to be 伝統的. I want it to be slow, right? Because if it's fast, it's kind of like, why? Are you so It almost like 逆に makes you feel like 違和感 like why is it fast?
Yeah,
don't be fast.
Yeah.
Like I want it to be like, you know, a message in a bottle type of thing. It's like I'm sending it out there and I'm letting nature do its work kind of thing, right? I don't want to be stressed out by the speed of postage. But on the one hand, obviously we live in a modern society and I think we should, you know, speed things up. Mm-hmm. However,
there's a beautiful thing about a letter, yeah. right? Like if I sent you an email, If I sent you a letter, a handwritten letter with designs and cursive and calligraphy and like shiru, wouldn't that mean so much more?
Oh, with the stamp, you close it and you put
the wax stamp.
Especially if you date it, like you date it like September 15th, 1821, and it gets to you. No, like December, or no, January the next year. Like, it's like, oh man, this place has been places, you know? This
you want to know?
Yeah, this letter has gone through.
So, China.
And so, when now, it's like you can send, like you're saying, you can send an email and it gets you right away. But now, letters get to you so quickly, it's basically like an email.
Yeah.
And it gets to you so quick, it's like, it, you know, the email has basically killed all intimacy when it comes to physical letters. But now that physical letters have gone so quick,What's the point?
Here's what you do.
何の話?
High tech.
I'm conflicted about the high tech innovations is what I'm saying. You know?
Here's what you do. When you're 15 years old, you go, Dear 25-year-old Byron. And then you set the date for like 10 years later. You go like, are you working now? Did you graduate college? I want to let you know everything's going to be okay. You know, you write to yourself for the future.That's the real thing to do.
That's actually a really cool idea. We'll do that today.
We should do that.
Set for 10 years from now?
Dude.
Oh, yeah. じゃあちょっとハイテクの話してもら
って。初めてハイテク感じてたのは、昔っていうのはいつも荷物を送るときに全部手書き、レーブルとか手書きで書かないといけないんじゃないですか。
今もそうじゃない。
うん。No, no, no. 今はまあネットで自分送りたいところの住所とか、ちゃんと入力したらそこで QR コードの生成できるんですよ、そこで QR を生成したらそのまま郵便局に行ってラベル印刷の機器があるんですねその QR リーダーがあってそれスキャンしたらラベルが印刷してくれます、
wow. めっちゃ便利じゃん
すごーい
これ、
そうです
Do they have them everywhere?
In all post office, yes.
Really?
Oh, this saves so much time.
I've used this before.
And not only, but I think it says is when you write by hand, sometimes some people's handwriting, you don't know if it's, is it a two or
a
one?
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
But if it's typewriter,
there will be less error.
Yeah.
Yeah, they always get my name wrong. They always think I'm a resource from StarCraft.They just call me Pylon.
Pylon. スマホで登録しといて、QR コードを読み取らせたら、
そう、そのまま貼ってくれ
た。シールが出てきて、宛先と自分の元。
そうです。
で、これをペッて貼って送れるってこと。
My image of sending emoji have to wait the counter and then have to write all the stuff.
Yeah.
Spend like 30 minutes just to just to go to the counter.
The thing is, this information transfers over when you try to send stuff on programs like Medicari.
Oh, yeah.
Medicari, so then all you do is that it already connects you to the other person. Bring up the QR code on Medicari. You print something out at the konbini, show the tain-san, and then they print out the seal for you. You would put it on, and then boom, it gets sent to the address.
Yes.
Konbini demo dekiru yo. Sakki no yatsu wa yūbinkyoku no sabisu da kedo, その Medicari だったらコンビニ行って同じようなことができるってこと
Yeah, you can send stuff from Medicari, yeah.
でもロッピーでできるんですね。
はあ。
ロッピーやキキで。キュアコードをスキャンしたら出してくれます。
よくロッピーとか知ってるね。
使ってましたから。
コンビニで荷物を依頼するっていうのはできる。
自分の国
うん。
ああ、できない。
多分できない
できないです。
No.
まずでき、no. できないかとか分からない。できても、しゅん。
The only thing that I think you can do in Romania but you can't do in Japan at the konbini is you can buy a SIM card and you can recharge your SIM card at the konbini in Romania.
That's cool.
That's それはいいよね。
It makes you think about like if you go to the konbini, it's like at first they're like a tain-san. They say, いらっしゃいませ! And then ちょっと配達できます? あ、できます! And they turn into a 配達 person. I want them to do that next time I send a package. I want them to twirl around and then they're changing uniform.
送れるのもすごいし、全国のコンビニと情報連携してるのもまたすごいよね、多分ね。
そうですね。どういうシステム使ってるのかわかんないですけど、でもすごいと思います。So speaking of company, have you guys seen this postage box in the company where you can put the parcel that you want to send?
宅配ボックスみたいなやつ。
そうそう。
見たことある。あれ何に使うの？
それも同じく QR コードスキャンしたらラベル貼って、あそこでボックス開けるね。そこで預けたら開けるっていう感じ。It's kind of like a 集荷センター。
So I feel if I live in a manga kisa, I can use that.
Manga. Yes.
That's right. Yes. Yeah, because I don't have an address. I can't use the address of the manga
kisa. Oh, you mean? Okay.
So then I could use the Amazon.Box at the konbini, and then that's my quote unquote home address.
Ah, これだけでいいんや。
ね。
え？すごいね。
Man, February is ahead of its time, dude.
だこのロッカーに荷物ポイって入れとくだけでいいんや。
そうです。
コンビニで送れるし、まあ受け取るボックスもあるよね。
うん。
ということでハイテクでした。ということで今日は海外が驚く日本の配達サービスの凄さについて話してみました。
どうだった日本人、
当たり前のことと思ってるでしょ。
そうね、いや確かに。あ、すいません、あの配達員の方が走ってるのを見てちょっとやりすぎかなというか、でも申し訳ないというか
頑張ってるんだ。
そんな頑張っていただいてもごめんなさいっていう気持ちにはなるのと、あのアマゾンとかで次の日の朝8時に届きますって言われたら、もう夕方なんだけど、なんかありがとうございますって感じだから、もっとありがたいと思わないといけないなっていう、ちょっと勉強になりました。他に皆さんが思う日本の高いサービスの凄さとかがあればコメント欄までよろしくお願いします。他に僕らに話してほしいトピックがあればコメント欄までそちらもよろしくお願いします。それでは次の動画でまたお会いしましょう。バイバーイ。チャンネル登録お願い
します。
うー。